Hello friends, today we are going to start with a new topic covered under the subject design of steel structure, that is column bases. Now what basically column bases means is understood from the name itself, that is base of the column. So this is the base of the column what we are going to study, but this time we are going to talk about the steel structure, that is steel column bases, right? So moving further, let us talk about the definitions and all. Column bases, also known as the base plates, are important joints which do not only take care of the forces but other aspects also, such as alignment of the column in the plan, verticality of the column, control deflection of the columns and beams. So at first, from the definition we would say that column bases is also known as base plate. This acts as a base plate for any steel column. So basically this also takes care about the forces and the alignments of the column in the plan. Now suppose if I have drawn a plan like this, structural plan, showing all the columns, one is over here, second is over here, third is over here. So the alignment of all three columns should be in a single line according to the plan, and its alignment is controlled by using this column bases. Secondly, verticality of the column. Now if we look column from the sideways, suppose I have made I section column, this is a I section column, ISBS. So the use of this column base is also to make the column exactly vertical. And like RCC structure only, we can also here check the verticality of the column by using a plumb bob. Then after, our next point is control deflection of the columns and beam. If we are using a column bases effectively and efficiently, then our deflections of the columns and beams can be controlled to a very high intensity. So this was some basic about the column bases. Now we already have some idea what is column bases theoretically. We have not yet seen the diagram of this, but we do have some idea regarding this. Now moving further, base plates are used for transmitting the load from the column to its foundation. Now for this we need to see the figure. Suppose we consider this figure. Here is the base plate. This one is our base plate and this is our column. So when there is loading coming from the top of the column, actually it gets transferred to the foundation by using this base plate. So this is the function of the main function we would say of the base plate, to transfer the load from the column to the foundation. Getting back to the slide. We understood the first point. The second is base plate assists in reducing the intensity of loading and distributing it over the foundation. The other thing our base plate is used is to reduce the intensity. The load is not concentrated on a single point. It is distributed evenly among the foundation. Then the third point is area of the base plate is so chosen that the intensity of load distributed is less than that of the bearing capacity of the concrete on which it rests. So getting back to the figure, what we just saw. Here the intensity of loading, what we saw here, that is coming actually on the column or a compression member, that should be less than that of the bearing capacity of this concrete block. This is our concrete block which is below the base plate, and base plate is supported on this block. So loading should be less than this. So this was some basic introductory part on the column bases and actually the base plates. We understood what is base plate, not the entire column base. Moving further, initially the column load is distributed to the, see here we are talking about the mechanism of the load transfer in column bases. So initially the column load is distributed over the base plate then to the supporting concrete. As we saw in the figure, the load, axial load that was coming on the member, that is distributed first on the column. From column to it is gets transferred to the base plate, and from the base plate it gets transported to the concrete block. So that is what is written over here. Distributed over the base plate, then to the supporting concrete, and finally to the soil. Because our concrete block is lying on the soil, ultimately the load will be transferred to the soil, such that the bearing capacity of soil is not exceeded. We are designing this column basis in such a way that the bearing capacity of soil is not exceeded beyond the limit. That is, our actual loading that is coming on our column is controlled to a very high limit. So friends, this was all about introductory part on the column basis. In next lecture, we'll be talking about types of column basis. So thank you for watching and have a nice day.